Hey guys, it's Becca. I really missed you guys, and I was supposed to talk last week, but we had this little mini quarantine again, so I'm gonna talk now, and I'm gonna do it in my car because my house is just like full of chaos, and you'd probably hear like a blender going in the background or something. So we're gonna have a little car talk today. So really what the Lord gave me for you guys was to talk about words. And I know that I've definitely gotten on some of you guys about the words that you're saying to each other, and I just don't like it when you guys are like messing around with each other. I know it's like, oh, we're just playing, like it's all fun and jokes and games. But words are super important. So that's why I always get on you guys about calling each other names or just picking on each other, just because they're super, super important. So this is what the Lord has for you guys. So first of all, I want you to know that the Bible says that the tongue has the power of life and death, which is the basis of what this little mini sermon is going to be on. So this might get a little heavy, all right, because this is what the Lord gave me, so I know that you can handle it if he gave it to me, right? But it's going to get a little heavy. I'm sorry, it's not going to be the most comfortable talk. It'll get better at the end, I swear. But this is what he gave me. So the tongue has the power of life and death. When I was thinking about that, I asked him at night, and I was just laying in bed like ready to go to sleep, and I was like, you know what, like God, like what do you have for me to give to the youth group? And he said this. So the first thing he said to me was about suicidal people. I told you it was gonna get heavy. But it's like in a good way though. So if you have the power of life and death in the words that you speak, and you met someone who is suicidal, would you speak life into them or would you speak death? And that's really important. Because if you can speak life into that person, you can save that person's life, because maybe they're just holding on for that one kind person, for that little last humanity that is in the world. And you could be that for them. You can speak life into them, and you can stop them from committing suicide and taking their own life. And that's really important to remember. And that is how powerful our words are, is we can save people. Or if you know someone who's unsaved and you talk to them about God, at least you're not just letting them go into eternity in hell. You're trying to talk to them and save their lives. And it's better to say something and to speak life than not to say anything at all. Because if that suicidal person went up to you and you said nothing to them, then you didn't help them, and you're pretty much saying in silence that you can die and that's okay. You can take your own life and we don't care. When you know that we do care, we really do care. And that's super, super important to remember. So there's that. But I also want you to know that if you don't talk to someone who's unsaved about God, then it's pretty much doing the same thing. It's saying you can go to an eternity in hell and I won't care, when you do care and you should care. So speak life, or if you don't say anything, then you're pretty much speaking death. Or you could say it directly. You could speak death directly. And that's just pretty much being like, no, like, you can go, you're stupid, or you're ugly, or you're fat, or you can go die. Like, that's speaking death. So are you seeing, like, how important words are, that you need to speak life to people, and you need to speak, most importantly, you need to speak. But you need to speak. So that was the first thing he said. Oh, the other thing I wanted to say about that is this, for a saved person, Earth is the closest, or for an unsaved person, this is the closest they will ever get to heaven. Think about it. They're here right now, and if they're unsaved, this is the closest they get to heaven. That's horrible. Because all we know that this Earth is not good, that the world we live in is chaotic and full of sin and horrible people. But this is the closest that unsaved people get to heaven. And we don't want it to be like that. We want to save them from this. So you need to talk to them about what their future is going to be and where they're going to end up. So it goes another way. Words not only affect other people, but they affect you too. And the enemy really likes to tell us that we're worthless, that we are unmendable, that no one loves us, that we're just here. And he can destroy you with his lies and his words. And he uses that weapon against you. But the thing is, the Bible says that the sword is the tongue. With the full armor of God, the sword is the tongue. So we can use that weapon against him too. And the weapon that we use is the word. And the word is what God says. So that's the third thing. These are God's words. God's words speak life into you and to others. So this is what God says about you. He says we are children of God. He says that you are loved with an everlasting love. He says you are knitted together. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. He says you are precious in his eyes and honored, and that he loves you. He says that he knew you before you were formed in the womb. Before anyone ever knew you were going to be here, he knew you. He says that you are a chosen race. But most importantly, nothing shows God's love for you like the crucifixion. Nothing. Because while you were still his enemy, he gave up everything for you so he could know you, so he could have this relationship with you. A while back, I gave this example of if your enemy was gonna die for the things that they did. And he said, the thing to save me would be for you to let your son die on the cross for me. Would you do it? No. You'd say, you're my enemy. That's my son. That makes no sense. No. But then, for some reason, say you turn crazy and you go, yeah, I'll let my son die. Does that absolutely make no sense? Yeah, it makes no sense. The only possible way it would make sense is if it was God and if it was Jesus. Because there's a reason, there's that purpose. So I want you to remember that. I know this was kind of short, but remember that. That you have the power of life and death in your tongue. Okay? Don't kill people with your tongue. I know sometimes it's fun to look at your friend and tease them, but those words hurt no matter how much you say, oh, we're just playing. We always say things like this. We're messing around. No matter what you say, those words do hurt. And even if you're messing around, sometimes it's not messing around for that person. Sometimes it really does deeply hurt them. So be careful of what you're saying to your friends and to your family, because it does hurt. Second thing, the beautiful thing about this is we could speak life. We can speak life into people. We can encourage other people. You can tell someone who they are in Christ. You can help them. And you could be the person who could save someone's life just by being kind. I can't remember what the saying was, but it pretty much says that be kind to every single person because you don't know what anyone really is going through at that moment. And it's so true. More importantly, words can affect you too. I forgot to tell you guys this, but also in the Bible, it says that the end, the judgment day, we will be counted for our words. Like, we will be judged for the words that come out of our mouths. So be careful what you say, because you can be judged for that at the end. Thank God we have the blood of Jesus, and that he knows we're sinners and we mess up. But you should still try. Try and watch what you say. And then the third thing, the devil puts you down with words. That is his weapon against you. That's why it is so crucial to know the Bible, because that's your weapon against him. So when he speaks death to you, you need to speak life. You need to say, no, I know who I am. I know who I am. Okay, the fourth thing, what God says about you. I want you to remember what he says about you. I will type out a list of these scriptures that I pulled from, and I'll give it to Jen so that I could give it to you guys. But remember what God says to you. I want you to think about that today. To think about how much he loves you. And just to meditate on it and to believe in it, most importantly. I think that's what I had for you guys. Yeah. It's so weird doing this. I kind of feel like I'm doing a vlog. Car vlog. Alright, guys. I love you. Speak life. Be nice. Talk to your friends in a nice way. There's different ways that you can mess with your friends. Better ways. Instead of being mean and crushing each other. Breaking each other down. Don't do that. That's not cool, bro. Okay. I love you. I can't wait to see you guys again. When Wednesday starts up again. Yeah, just have a good day. I love you. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. God loves you. You are his child. You get it today! I love you! Bye.